Namibia is currently experiencing the most difficult economic times in its history. The Pharmaceutical Society of Namibia reported that nearly 50 pharmacies closed down in recent years due to the economic climate. However, there are some in the industry that are eager to succeed. One of them is medical equipment distributor Shipanga Medical Services.
I want to appeal for the support of our government, our leaders, national, regional, local. You are our leaders. We need your support, because without your support, we believe there's nothing that we can get done. Equally, we've got clinics, we've got the hospital here. We want to service the hospitals in Ochodonjupa region. We've got 14 regions, Honorable Minister. We need to create partnerships. Why should this hospital, which is just a stone throw away here, when they need gloves, when they need medicine, when they need certain urgent supplies, why can't we just make it available to them so that they can provide the service to the people? So everything sometimes is just complicated through all sorts of unnecessary processes. So from our side, we are ready to play that role.
Shipanga aspires to venture into manufacturing medical products and reach across the border to supply the over 300 million SADC market in the near future. In his speech, the Minister of Health and Social Services said that this is in line with the government's long-term vision of promoting local manufacturing in the private sector.
We are encouraged to note that Shipanga Medical Services was not only set up to supply and benefit the Namibian market, both public and private, but equally to grow into the regional and continental markets. This is a bold commitment, and we wish to assure you that our government will support such initiative.
Now, the Minister of Health, Minister Shangula, is not the only national leader here today. Here we have the Deputy Minister of National Enterprises, Mr. Vaiko Nekundi. Mr. Vaiko, we saw in the speech of the Executive Director of these medical services, Mr. Martin Shipanga, emphasizing a lot on the support that he has gained from government side, which has obviously enabled his business to thrive. Can you tell us if government is in fact doing its job in terms of ensuring that there is a conducive environment for the private sector during this tough economic times?
Thank you very much. Indeed, I'm very much pleased to see that the Minister of Health is present at the inauguration. In fact, he inaugurated this very wonderful facility of Shipanga Medical Services. Your question is very much imperative. Namibia government, under the Swakopmund leadership, is only not providing the conducive environment at the moment. So the conducive environment have been provided by our government since the 21st of March 1990. That is 29 years down the line. That is the environment that we have been creating for the business people and the entrepreneurs to thrive in whatever economic sector they wish to participate. It has been a testimony that a number of local investments that have been taking place in this country, and they have thrived very successfully. Yes, of course, there are some of the challenges, but at the broader context, and possibly at the rate of 10, possibly 9 out of 10 local enterprises have thrived in the activities.
Okahandja is a town of 40,000 people, and yet it only has one clinic and one hospital to date. The mayor of the town, Johannes Injo, has urged the business community to build health facilities as such. Reporting for Today on One, I'm Joseph Shifeni.